It's been a late arriving spring at the UT Gardens, but the true stars of the state's prettiest science lab are making their grand entrance. The Beal family rose garden is coming alive with beauty. Roses come in every color but blue, and they have an almost universal effect on people.
Even if you're in the hospital, you feel better when somebody walks in with a bouquet of roses.
Dr. Mark Windham of UT Ag Research doesn't just admire roses, he studies how to grow better ones. In Tennessee, we produce roses mostly for the wholesale nursery business. And while our total numbers aren't that high, what we do grow is first rate in quality.
A good rose has three components. First of all, it's got to have a good root system. It's got to have healthy foliage. And of course, we want strong stems holding the blooms.
Specifically, Windham is now studying a disease that greatly impacts the floral industry.
But right now, most of our research is focused on rose rosette, which is a virus disease of roses. And unfortunately, from a national point of view, Tennessee wasn't the first place it was found, but Tennessee is considered ground zero now because it's so severe here.
We grow about 175 different roses here at the UT Gardens on the Ag Campus. And very soon, one of those varieties will be on display at the Tennessee Governor's Mansion. Tennessee First Lady Chrissy Haslam was recently presented with a special no-spray rose developed by UT Ag Researchers. The past 8 years, UT Ag Researchers have been working with roses that can grow in hot, humid climates, but don't need fungicide sprays to avoid disease. Mrs. Haslam has plans for a public garden at the Governor's Mansion, and the rose bush will be planted there.
Of course, I don't know, what woman doesn't like roses, right? So I'm very happy to have this new rose bush to put in the garden and to use and bring in the house and use in arrangements at the residence.
The rose has been called the queen of the garden. This time of year, when we look to treat our moms like queens, what better way to do that than to give her something that looks like this? This is Chuck Denny reporting.